So next, we're going to take a look at the binomial distribution. Minitab does not calculate the probability of the binomial distribution. They're not asking me for an x value. They're not asking me for a probability. They're giving me a probability. So this has to be crunched by hand. The problem is with crunching this by hand, there's a lot of space for rounding mistakes. So I'm going to suggest that for this, you can use the StatTrek binomial distribution calculator. I'm going to put a link to it in the announcements with this video. And when we're using this calculator, it asks you for three things. So it asks you for the probability of success, the number of times they have to do something, and then how many successes we want to have. So looking at this problem, it says the soccer team has not won a game this season. Not really relevant to us. They have 4 matches left. That's the number of trials. So it's how many coin flips you're gonna make, it's how many games you have left, it's the value of how many times they could possibly do something. If the probability of them winning each of the remaining matches is 0.05, which is 5%, find the probability of them winning at least one game. So the way that goes into the calculator is that the 5% is entered as a decimal, just like when we do it in Minitab. The number of trials is the 4 games they have left. So they have 4 more shots to win. The number of successes that we want, according to this problem, is at least one time. So that you'll notice these gray shaded boxes are here, and I don't have it cleared out, but when you actually enter it, these gray boxes are empty. So the instinct is like click, 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 trying to get it to right in here and put a 1 because it's greater than. That's not the case. The 1 actually goes here. Then you click calculate, and then you go to which one of these is what they asked me for. If it's at least 1, that would be greater than or equal to 1. So it is 19% is our answer. So again, you have to recognize the probability being 0.05. We have 4 games left that we could win. So that 4 is going to be my number of trials. The number of successes is how many times you want to do the thing. So I want to win at least one time. I put that in. If it was win exactly one time, it'd be 17%. If it was to win less than once, 81%. If it was to win greater than once, not greater than or equal to, it would be the 1.4. Because I want at least one, that is greater than or equal to, which is 19%.